What up, YouTube? It's your boy Tony. We back with another one. Our boy Shady dropped the official video for Hire. Music to be Murdered By B-side was just the whole project of Music to be Murdered By is just a damn masterpiece. Like, y'all can't tell me that ain't like, I got it. To me, it moved up to like top three projects. Like, it gotta be. It gotta be, bro. It's like, what, over 20 songs of just fire, bro. Like, what? Like, you might, what, just pass over one just because you don't like a certain sound, like Stepdad or something like that. Like, you don't want, hey. Like, people ain't all into that. But the song itself and the, like, the little storytelling is dope. You know? Like, it's not a trash song on the project, A or B side. You know? It's just crazy. So, he dropped the official video for Hire, which is, like, the main theme song for the little Conor McGregor fight that's coming up on UFC and all that. So, looking forward to seeing what the video is about. And I like this track, man. It gets you hype. It sounds like an anthem. Like, if this was, like, rocking in the stadium, like, with, like, 50,000 people, that shit would be crazy, bro. But I appreciate y'all, man. Continue to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Wolfpac, I appreciate all the love. If you're new here, a little bit longer breakdown slash reactions because I play the whole song, try to catch everything if I can. If not, Wolfpac be in the comments with me, helping me out, figure it all out. All right, Wolfpac, without further ado, let's go!
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's Jay. You
know, I've been around for a while now. Not sure if I have much left to prove. Yeah, I do. I look at me now, I'm thinking, damn. How proud of me I am. What I did is nothing to sneeze at. Even if your allergies are bad. I'm up in the balcony in France. I look around, I see the fans. How they surround me in the stands. Probably could drown in a sea of hands. They're hollering Shady.
Ah, I love that part, bro. How they surround me, like I could probably drown in a sea of hands. Like, there's that many people out there, bro. He said, what I've done is nothing to sneeze at. Even if your allergies are bad, like, you still won't sneeze at what I've done. Like, that's one of the reasons he went at Snoop, because it seemed like Snoop was just like, and what he did when he said, you know, that shit, I could live without that shit. Like, it's like, what? Like, hold on. Like, it's like you, like you just dismissing my shit. Like, what I did throughout my career. Like, oh, yeah, I could just live without that. That's why he took offense to it. Snoop has now apologized, or I don't know if he apologized, but he said, you know, that's family business. Like, they still good. They cool now. So I'm guessing they had a conversation and squashed it. Like, you know, I think really after the whole Dre scare that it really like stopped anything that would have possibly happened, because, you know, Dre is tied to both of them, and it's like, oh, hell no. We almost lost Dre. Yeah, we got to squash this shit, especially over nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, Snoop just was out of line, and Eminem responded with a little, okay, and, you know, the world went crazy. But yeah, this song's so fucking hype.
Yelling it out to me, and that's what I mean when I say that one day, some way, somehow, if I get the chance to get a crowd, I flip it around and have a crowd give me the chance. I've done it all, man.
But a chance and chance, bro. That's crazy wordplay. I've done it all, man. Shady getting ready for a fight. Go ahead. Shady can really box, too. He's been training for like, what do you say, like 15 some years. So he got hands. There's no way he got a smart-ass mouth, slick-ass mouth like he do, and he don't got hands. He's been training. I know that. Before y'all just think y'all gonna run up on him and whoop his ass. Like, okay, good luck.
In actuality, I haven't yet. Where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, really, I have no idea. Oh, all I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. Let's go. Got no time for no haters in this bitch. Or toleration for the shit, but like medication, my dedication and the time it takes to do this shit reminds me of how an overcrowded hospital waiting room would get. What I mean is maybe I have more patience than I'm able to admit. Yeah, but I'm still mentally
like an overcrowded hospital and you're waiting to be admitted. Like, he's saying, like, basically I got more patience than I'm willing to admit. patients in the hospital waiting in the waiting room, I got more patience than I'm willing to admit. Like I say, I'm short fused and all that, but and that I don't want to deal with all this shit in the rap game, but maybe I really do, because I'm in it still after this long. Like maybe my patience is not as thin as I may say, as I may put on for them to be. I got a lot of patience for this shit, and I'm willing to stick through it all just to keep rapping.
Stable is a three-legged table in this bitch. Fame was a switch, but I was grateful to trade the shit for the trailer with a hitch that it would make me a raving lunatic. But I made it through my situation, I hit pay dirt, now I get paper like a stapler in this bitch. But just cause I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit.
Paper like a stapler, because I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit. Like I haven't changed at all. Come on, Shady got bars, bro.
Dangerous, can't distinguish this English language when it's lit, and I'm just berating you with it. It's Shady till I'm 82.
Wait. Connor with the Connor walk.
In this bitch, but just cause I made a little bit of change don't mean I've changed a little bit. Brain full of wit, dangerous, can't distinguish this English language when it's lit, and I'm just berating you with it. It's Shady till I'm 82. I spit this crazy, even Dre, he knows I'm a blow. Better get the handkerchief again.
So where am I supposed to go from here? Oh, hey. Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
No, I talk about this shit a lot, but
where am I supposed to go from here?
If we learn anything from watching 8 Mile is that when it comes to battle rap, don't come for Eminem. He will be the first to tell you that he treats the rap game the same way the world's best athletes treat their respective sport, with a 24/7 tenacity that only the elite are able to channel.
Eminem confirmed for upcoming fight. So this is the little snippet I was seeing where people thought Eminem was really on ESPN going at Dana White or whatever. But apparently it was just a part of this video. Every time people think they caught Eminem doing something, it just be part of a video. Y'all remember, like, it was that video of him with a chick in the hotel and shit. Everybody thought they caught him with somebody. Like, no, it was a music video. Y'all not finding out what Eminem's doing in his personal life. You won't know unless he tells us.
He spent his entire life studying and training to be the best, but even with a life of preparation, will it be enough for his next battle? It's one thing to conquer your competition. It's another to conquer your demons. With us now to share his thoughts is Dana White, who knows a thing or two about marquee battles. Dana, thanks for being with us. How prepared can one be when going up against an opponent of this magnitude?
Yeah, thanks for having me. Listen, I'm a huge Eminem fan, but this is a tough one. This opponent is not someone you can prepare for. It's a tricky demon to conquer, even for someone as badass as Eminem. My prediction is disappointment for fans all over the world.
That's interesting. We are now joined.
My prediction is disappointment for fans all over the world. So even Dana White don't believe in my boy, man. You gotta believe. Do you still believe in me? Didn't I give you everything? Whatever, I lost the fucking rhythm, but y'all know the song.
By the man himself, Eminem. M, appreciate it. What's your response to what Dana just said?
I want to say, first of all, thank you for having me on. I think that people like you give people like me the fuel that they need to succeed in the first place. So I think that the best part about your opinion is that it doesn't matter. And if every fighter that you had listened to your opinion when you doubted them, you wouldn't have a f-ing league. So you're an a-hole, and I'm out.
Well, he definitely...
If they have it on ESPN, they would have a mental conniption. Somebody calling somebody an asshole and saying a fucking opinion on ESPN, they would have lost their mind.
He sounds ready. In any case, it should be a battle for the ages. Thank you, Dana, and best of luck to you, Eminem.
That's funny, bro.
Nothing homie, I'm on the loose. Born a winner, never so hard to lose. I can do it even when I'm trying to. With my record flop, I still go through the roof. This atmosphere is for a chosen few who was on their grind making money moves. And you ain't gonna get there if you water down. You gotta take shots with 100 proof.
Been in survival mode. since a 5-year-old. It was I alone since my trike was stole's viral notebook and microphone. But looking back how bad it was then, if it hadn't have been for the pad of the pen addict, mom and dad beat dad, I wouldn't have had the savage within, having to win every single battle I'm in. All I ever wanted was to be an MC. Tediously I wrote obediently, believing in me. EPMB must have had teaching me.
He barring on that bro, bro. Barring, bro. That's just crazy. Like, tediously, come on, bro. He said, if it wasn't for everything I went through, like, I wouldn't have had the will and the fight to do what I was doing.
Like, mom and dad beat dad, I wouldn't have had the savage within, having to win every single battle I'm in. All I ever wanted was to be an MC. Tediously, I wrote obediently, believing in me. EPMB must have had teaching degrees. Learned to defeat enemies with the ink. Thinking of these rhymes would be as easy as E. And graffiti would be like remedial reading to me. To my last breath, these my lungs. I'ma beat my drum for the streets I'm from. The east side slums, gotta remind them. I'll take a foe out like feet by thumb. You see my finger, you see my thumb. You see my fist for the east pipe. I'm here for the smoke, but it's not the weed I want. With this beat I brung for the beef I've come. But you better bring it if you wanna reply from.
This beat I brung, I run the beat for the beef that I want. Like this smoke that I on, ain't no weed and none of that. I brought the beat, and if you want to hop on it with me, then let's do it.
If I'm here for the smoke, but it's not the weed I want. With this beat I brung for the beef I've come, but you better bring it if you want to reply from. Cause for you to be lyrically inclined, it'd be a steep climb up. That'll be an uphill battle, but I'm up like your feet in a recliner. And
I'm up in your feet like a recliner. Come on, man. And he said you got to be lyrically inclined, as is. You have to be lyrically inclined. That was not lyrically inclined. That's why the other ones got you. That's why Knox got you. That's why DK got you. Because this, you didn't want this.
I think I'm about to go out on a limb like a tree climber. Time to push my ceiling higher. Because where am I supposed to go from here? Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been. Where am I supposed to go from here? Really, I have no idea. All I know is every time I think I hit my ceiling, I go higher than I've ever fucking been.
Go Shady. And I knew I should have sent in that damn video where he asked for people to record themselves singing the song. I knew I should have did that shit. I could have been on there. Alright, Wolfpac, man. Y'all tell me what y'all felt about the video. I love that song, man. That is an anthem. And the first, like, whatever big event we able to have, and there's going to be a lot of people when they play that shit, it's going to be crazy. Or if he ever to have a concert, that's gonna go crazy. I appreciate y'all, man. Continue to like, comment, subscribe, and share. If you're new here, go ahead and subscribe. Turn on the notifications, y'all. Follow your boy on Twitter. Link is in the description below. Appreciate y'all. Wolfpac, we'll be back. Let's go!